It wasn't just that the patient was a 400-pound tiger that made this a hairy operation. We mean really hairy, as in gigantic hairball.
Oh.
And that was just the first clump removed from Ty the tiger's stomach.
He's sort of like my biggest baby. This is my kid.
Vernon Yates raised Ty at his Florida wildlife refuge, but lately the 17-year-old tiger hadn't been acting like himself. Over a three-week period, Ty ate less and less. His weight dropped 100 pounds. A vet put a scope down his throat. Diagnosis: hairball. It turns out a tiger gets a hairball the same way a house cat does, by licking and grooming himself. Only most cats, like Puss in Boots, manage to hack up the obstruction.
Hairball.
But Ty's hairball was way too big to cough up. Doctors at Blue Pearl Vets offered to operate without charge. The press pressed up against the window.
Wow.
Mesmerized as doctors removed clump after clump from Ty's stomach.
Holy cow. Another one of those.
Oh. Finally, the doctor dropped the whole mess into the arms of Ty's owner.
Show it to us.
Show it to us.
I'm gonna give it to you.
I don't want it!
It weighed in at 4 pounds, petite compared to the 167-pound human hairball that a Missouri barber collected from years of clipping clients. But then the barber didn't swallow that hairball.
This is where we separate men and boys.
Separated from his hairball, Ty's prognosis was good, and the doctors praised their patient.
This tiger specifically is a very, very nice, very, very sweet tiger.
So what do you do with a 4-pound hairball? Ty's owner says they thought about selling it on eBay. But apparently selling something from an endangered species gets tricky, so the plan is to just throw it away. It was as if Ty gave birth to his own little bundle of fur. Ginny Mo, CNN.
Looks like a rodent.
New York.